So, Biswajit, congratulations first of all for clearing your UGC NET exam.
Thank you so much.
And we are really happy to have you with us for this video session.
Same here. Great to see you also.
Fine. So let's start with the question number one that I want to ask. Tell us something about yourself, your educational qualification and courses that you have purchased before giving NET.
Okay, so I'm Biswajit Sharma. I was born and brought up in Assam. Mm-hmm. And I'm a BCom graduate. Okay. And after BCom, I joined IMT Hyderabad to pursue Master's in Finance. Mm-hmm. I'm an MBA student and I'm in first year.
So when did you start your preparation for NET and like how did you prepare for it? Did you join some coaching, some offline classes or you prepared by self only?
To be honest, it started all of a sudden. I just wanted to see how UGC NET exam is all about. Mm-hmm. And I also filled the form on the last day of registration. Mm-hmm. And if you ask me about preparation, I watched some videos on YouTube channel, that is Anuj Jindal, mm-hmm. and some PDF that I found online. And these were really helpful.
Mm-hmm. And what were the books and study materials that you used for your preparation, Biswajit?
As I said, some YouTube videos and some PDFs that I found online, and course books were sufficient for the preparation. That's what I felt.
Didn't you purchase any other specific books to clear the UGC NET exam?
No, nothing.
Okay. And what has been your daily routine and how much time you have devoted for the preparation of NET?
I think you should not ask a daily routine to an MBA student because we hardly get any time to prepare a timetable.
Right.
So, strategy was quite simple, to score as much as possible in the paper one. Mm-hmm. Because we as an MBA student, we already have cleared exams like CAT, JET, NMAT, all those things. Mm-hmm. And I already had good command over quantitative aptitude, logic, DI, and CLOGs, all these, and mm-hmm. just few topics like teaching aptitude and research aptitude. I have gone through the basics of that, and by looking at the question, for me, it was easy to solve.
Okay. And what were the difficulties that you faced during the preparation, and how did you tackle those difficulties?
I faced difficulty in paper two because as I'm the first year, some topics were still unknown to me. And to be honest, I had my basics clear in few of the papers like accounting, finance, and economics. So I had gone basic concept of those subjects, and it was sufficient to get over 50% in that paper.
Okay. And how useful were the past year papers and the mock test if you have taken, and how many mock tests you have taken, Biswajit? Because I believe that many people, many students and aspirants, they are confused that how many mock tests we should use or either we should take mock test or not.
Actually, I didn't take any mock test, but I solved last 2 years question paper and those were really helpful.
So according to you, mock tests are useful or not? Like people should take it or not?
Since I haven't taken any mock test, I will be not the right person to comment on it. Okay. But if you're preparing for it with heart and soul, then definitely you should give mock, because that is not the only thing to know your level of preparation. Mm-hmm. And accordingly, you can go through your weaknesses.
Okay, Biswajit. And what are your plans for future after clearing your NET exam? Teaching or PhD or some other specific plan that you have for the future?
I wish to pursue PhD because it is the highest educational qualification. Mm-hmm. And it's always great to have one. And to be honest, it's very early to comment or decide whether I'll be doing job or teaching. I want to complete my education first.
Right. So, Biswajit, one advice that you would like to give to the students regarding the preparation?
I can suggest the same strategy that I used, that is to try scoring maximum in paper one, because as management students, you already are good in quants, logic, all these areas. So put some extra effort on the areas that you are not familiar with. As in my case, these were research aptitude and teaching aptitude in paper one. And for paper two, just go through your textbooks. All the topics are covered in class. And if you will find some online PDFs as well, where you will get shortcuts. Some topics are given in very short forms. You can remember those. And once you see the question, it becomes easier for you by looking at the option and you can tick on the correct. So that was my strategy. And I would suggest to all the candidates who are appearing for the June 2020 attempt.
Right. So thank you so much, Biswajit, for your advices.
Thank you so much.